do it again.
The most important kind of building block of my process is to read the script sort of in one extended sitting. I'm taking notes and I'm thinking about, okay, how is this scene meant to work? What is it meant to do? How are we meant to feel as we're watching it? How do I achieve that feeling? Those questions, along with how do I transitionally move from one thing to the next? How do I kind of create a movement of the story?
She is so prepared. She's at once both incredibly collaborative and open to ideas, but at the same time, she knows exactly what she wants and has a point of view.
If you think that way, then you can sort of say, okay, this scene, I can be in the location, work with the actors, rehearse and block, and have a pretty strong sense of how I'm going to shoot it. Whereas this scene, for instance, the bank robbery that takes place in the middle of the film, I knew that that was only going to work if I storyboarded pretty much every frame. There can't be mistakes or surprises. We were using live fire. There was a lot of in-camera live effects that had to be achieved. And so you can't just endlessly do that. You actually have to sort of say, okay, I get three shots or I get two shots at this effect of something blowing up.
All right, there's gunfire, loud noises, and action.
So I had to kind of be thinking in a more methodical and strategic way with some of those kind of scenes.